Exhausted. We're heading to Wilmington today, so we stopped at Hard Work in Raleigh. Got some deadlift instruction for sumo by my coach Evan. Moved a lot better, really smooth. Bench moved really good. We had a tempo top set of 308 at RP5. Felt very fast, very quick on the way up. I'll take that. Other than that, we're just chilling, doing some upper body in the beginning of the session, and then we're gonna go to some lower body, leg press, Bulgarians, and I think calf raises. Absolutely hate Bulgarians, especially for like the last two blocks. Like, I really liked them maybe like 6 months ago, but right now I'm just having so much pain in my hamstring. Not pain, but like just tightness when I'm going down. It's killing me. But it's all right, it's not that big of a deal. I'd still do the movement. I just feel like I'm a little, like I'm just not loading it the amount I need to. I'm just kind of cheating myself out. By week four, I want to be doing like 80, 85 for each dumbbell in my hand. So we'll see how that goes. But right now, just feel so, just flashy on Bulgarian. It's one of my least favorite right now.
One of my local lifters, I see them every day. So their feedback is right there in real time and doesn't really require any type of formality of any kind. There are some lifters that are like, hey man, you don't have to look at my lifts every day, just maybe once a week. You know, I'm like, all right, cool. When they say shit like that, I'm like, hey, I'll take you up on that. So. And there's just some lifters that don't respond well to over-feedbacking, I guess it's just over-coaching.
Yeah.
They just like are so, they don't have all the information.
Yeah, if it's a lot, yeah.
One, two.
All right, so that's my back down Larson's. Top set was a single at 330 for tempo, so it was just 4 seconds down, 1 second pause. Felt decent, not too bad. RPE 6, definitely right on the money for that. I was going for somewhere in between like 312 and 330, but I think 330, I just wanted that top end. Because by week 4, right now we're programmed to be somewhere between 358, 370. And honestly, I want to push it and get 3 reds. So that'd be 374. But we'll see. I'm feeling really good right now. Larson's just take a lot out of me. By like rep 4 or 5, I'm cooked. We did some lifting while traveling. We went to Hard Work last Friday. Today is Friday. So we went to Hard Work in Raleigh last Friday. And then we trained at Legacy in Wilmington on Sunday. Yep, because I shot Battleship Classic, or Battleship Open in Wilmington, and that was at Unleashed Fitness, also in Wilmington. Really nice meet. It was only one platform, 44 or 42 lift or something like that. And honestly, the setup was really easy. Like, it was nice and smooth, no issues, running all the cables, everything like that, and doing one platform definitely was a lot nicer than doing two. We did have to sit on the floor. But it's whatever. My hip flexors were kind of cooked for 2 days. And you can kind of see that in my squatting videos on Instagram from when we were at Legacy. But that's all right. But lifting while traveling, it gives you a chance to really see different gyms and also just become part of a larger community. I mean, I was able to meet people that either haven't seen in a while, like being at that meet and shooting it. I was able to connect a little bit deeper with Matt, who is one of the people that runs Legacy, and so that was nice. And then just being around the people in the powerlifting community just really helps change your perspective on a lot of things, so it gives you an opportunity to do that. And obviously being at Hard Work, I was able to work with Evan, so we worked on my deadlift. That was pretty good. And then this callus reopened up, not when we were deadlifting, but actually this week. I was sitting at work and I picked it. When you know you're going to a spot that has a powerlifting gym, just go to it. I mean, they'll probably have a day pass. Hit them up. If it doesn't clearly say on their website, you can usually shoot them an Instagram DM. But definitely worth it, especially if it gives you the opportunity to try out equipment that you may not have access to anywhere near you. So that's nice. But I would definitely recommend it. I always love doing it, especially like when we went to New Jersey and when we went up through Maryland, we got to check out a couple gyms up there, which was really nice. And that's always something I'm looking forward to when I go on vacation, is being able to train in a different environment just to see like who's there, what's there, and you know, how I can be more known in the community, but also how I can know the community itself more too, because everyone has their own role to play and everyone communicates differently and everyone has their own unique experiences. So just talking with people, meeting people, and getting to know them can be really impactful, give you a new set of eyes to see like how other people view the world, view powerlifting, how other people view this niche and what they do differently than you, right? So it's just like with anything, knowing different people can widen your mind, really. But that's basically all I got today. I have to hurry up and finish the rest of my workout because I have to go to work in less than 30 minutes, 35 minutes. Yeah, 35 minutes. So I got to superset everything, including leg press and Bulgarians. So that'll be fun. But as always, guys, I love you. Bye. Yeah. I don't know if she can stand anymore. I don't know if she can stand anymore. She doesn't think I'm a man anymore. No, she doesn't think I'm a man anymore. No, no.